Welcome back, guys. In this new video, we're going to take a look at the nature of light. Now, what we should realize is the visible light that we see with our eyes, it only represents a small section of all the possible lights that exist. The visible light that we see has a certain energy tied with it. Now, there are light sources that are above that energy and below that energy. Taking into account all of these different types of energies, we have this image right here. This is known as our electromagnetic spectrum. And you should see that we have here, these are gamma rays, we have X-rays, UV, here this is infrared, IR. Now, between UV, which is ultraviolet light, and IR, which is infrared light, that's where we find our visible light spectrum. And we're gonna say our visible light spectrum, the range is really 390 nanometers to about 780 nanometers. And we learned this in school, Roy G. Biv. So Roy G. Biv. And remember, what does that stand for? We're gonna say red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. Now, we're gonna say here, it looks like violet. Violet is around 400 nanometers, whereas red is around 780 nanometers. Okay? But remember, the visible light spectrum only represents a small section of the entire spectrum of colors. Now, after IR, there is microwave. Then we have radio waves, which we get in our car radios or at home on our stereos. So we have FM, and then we have radio in between, AM. And then we have long radio waves. Okay? These represent basically all the different types of light sources or light energies that exist. There's also cosmic rays, which are usually above gamma, but professors usually ignore those.